What's good, Chicago? It's the Wake Up and Win Show with Don Julio, Jazzer Fierce, and DJ Young Homie.
Hey, hey, hey. Welcome back to the Wake Up and Win Show. It's your girl, Jazzer Fierce, and DJ Young Homie. We are missing Don Julio today, but hey, you're here with us today, and we appreciate y'all being here. Good morning. I want to know how everyone's weekend was, so definitely drop it in the comments. What did you do this weekend? How was it? It was actually chilly for the first time, you know, this weekend.
It was.
But I'm happy about it. As I said, fall is my favorite season, so bring on the breeze. Bring on the cool breeze.
Whenever you say fall and all that, I just think of these old commercials where Gap, where it was fall into the Gap, and it just comes to mind right now. That's all.
Like Gap, like the clothing line?
Yeah, they used to have these commercials back in the early 2000s where they'd show the transition from summer to fall, and people would be bummed out, and then they'd be like, just fall into the Gap.
I like that. That's creative. I really like that. Hey, even though it sounds kind of
cheesy.
Yeah. Like right. Fall into the Gap. It's like the gap of what? You know?
Oh. Well, man, if you guys have a gap you want to fill in, leave a comment below.
Okay, exactly. So, and definitely make sure to follow us on Instagram. We're live on Twitter. We're live on Facebook. Our Facebook page is Wake Up and Win. Twitter is at Wake Up Win Show. And Instagram, of course, is at Wake Up and Win Show. So you really don't want to be not following us on Instagram and Twitter and Facebook and all of that. Like, it will really behoove you to follow us so you can know what's going on next with the show. You feel me?
Exactly. Yeah. I definitely feel you, Jasmine. It behooves you to definitely check us out online. But today, our outline is as follows. We have a great entertainment report. We got the weather update. We also have a top five with DJ Khaled. Today, I had to put that Khaled voice on it. And of course, we have quite the interview today with Mr. Trae Till, multi-talented artist, if I do say so myself, and such a smooth talker.
Okay. I'm telling you. The voice. Captivating.
We also have a free pizza giveaway. So you guys got to give up for 1363 Home Team Pizza. That's their address, right? 1363 West Ohio Street.
West Ohio. Yes, sir.
There you go. So leave a comment below.
Yes, if you want that free pizza. And we're just letting you know right now that you are listening to WLGK Logic Radio. Don't forget to download the app if you have an app store. Everyone has an app store.
Don't we? Everyone. Yeah, you're right. 100.
Yeah. Androids, Apple phones. I think even the brick phones, you know, flip phones, they got something to download apps. So, hey, get Logic Radio. Make sure you download that. Or you can listen live at logicradio.live. But next up, we're going to play a little bit of music, a little bit of promos, and we're going to be right back with my entertainment report.
Awesome.
Peace out, Girl Scouts.
The Wake Up and Win Show. Live on YouTube.
Twice a week, every week, we're giving away a free pizza, courtesy of Home Team Pizza. Just listen to the Wake Up and Win Show every Monday and Wednesday on YouTube or Facebook and leave the pizza emoji in the comments. That's all you gotta do. Home Team Pizza only uses fresh ingredients and they keep it local like your favorite sports team. Home Team Pizza, it's about family. What's up, everybody? Welcome back to the Wake Up and Win show. It's your girl, Jazza Fierce, and of course, we got DJ Young Homie right to the left of me.
I don't know why I did that, but it felt good.
It did, and I want you to do what feels good. You know, that's all that matters. It's okay. So, first up with this entertainment, Will Smith actually just came out in an interview, and he said that he actually wanted an extramarital affair with Halle Berry, you know, while he was, of course, still married to Jada Pinkett Smith. And I want to know, like, what's everybody's opinions on that? Because we all know about the whole, you know, the entanglement with Jada and with August Alsina that happened. I think that was last year. A lot happened during the pandemic. Like, absolutely. Was that last year?
I think it was last year, yeah, because they had that song. It was 2019, an entanglement with August. Entanglement.
Oh,
with
yeah, August. Yeah, yeah. Yes, because everything has to be a song nowadays. Why not? It makes it more fun. So, yeah, I definitely want to know you guys' opinions on that. Like, from, let me get like some female perspective, some guys in the comments. Like, let us know what you guys think. Like, is it bogus or petty for Will to say, like, yeah, I wanted to, you know, get with Halle while I was married to Jada, because Jada already, you know, stepped out on their marriage and had her entanglement with August Alsina. So I just want to know what you guys think. Corley says they're both unfaithful, but if it works for them, so be it.
You know what? Yeah. That's actually, that's if you tie a ribbon on it and present it, that's the best way to say it, I think. You know, like, nobody's perfect, but yeah. I see unfaithful A, unfaithful B, potentially, not saying he was, but come on. I think the intent is just as bad as the commitment.
Yeah, me too. Me too. Because it's like the thing about, I mean, I've never been married. So this is just like my personal opinion on things and how I feel. But I feel like if you decide to marry somebody, I mean, I get the whole like open marriage thing. But it's like at the same time, I just don't really understand and grasp that concept like other people do. My mom says they do what they do, but he shouldn't name names. I think Will Smith being low-key a little messy. Like, I think he's just a little bit. Like, maybe he's taking this time to kind of get back at Jada. I don't know. Because I'm like, yeah, you're right. He didn't have to name names. He didn't have to say Halle Berry. He could have just said, you know, somebody, you know. This person, he or, you know, she who should not be named type thing. But no, he said Halle Berry came out right with it. So I don't know. That's a, maybe he was just trying to be petty or I don't know.
True. Yeah. Yeah. I can see he's making a shot there. But also, like, I pulled up the GQ article right here. Here's a great photo of Will himself.
And yes, article, Will.
And the article is titled Get to Know the Real Will Smith. I'm digging it. I'm digging it. I mean, this is a great photo too, but I'm all about this. What is this? Leopard? Cheetah? You know?
Cheetah. Cheetalicious.
Cheetalicious, you know? It's,
yes.
Maybe he's coming to his own. Maybe he has a project that he's building when it comes to filming. He has another film on the way, and maybe he's trying to like build up some sort of promotion. But honestly, I've been married. Heck, I'm divorced. And I was engaged again too. I'll tell you from a perspective from a male who was in a relationship and that was married. When you commit, you commit. Even just thinking about it shows that you're drifting off the path. The path was supposed to be you and her, or her and you. Or nowadays, you know, her and her, him and him, which is great. Whoever your partner is, you guys are supposed to team up and take this is not a straight and narrow path, but hit the road together. Figure it out. Grow together. Learn skills. Right. Maybe if you'd like to raise children, these are all great things that require, you know, two people to come together and agreement mutually and respect each other. I know when I was married, I wouldn't even think to even say that out loud. One, because, you know, it's low key against the vows that I stated during my marriage ceremony. Right. And two, you know, I was low key a little intimidated. You know, I was married to a Latina. So you don't want to, you know, get them mad. Heck, you don't want to get any woman mad, period.
True.
Yeah. And then I suffered from infidelity. She herself chose to, you know, have an entanglement herself. and I don't want to go into too much detail, put her on blast. But yeah, it really was a shock to me. I was not appalled, not like, yeah, I was a little sad, but more importantly, I was disappointed. I thought, yo, like, you're coming here, I'm meeting you halfway, and we're going to do this together. Obviously, she had other intentions in mind. I think Will is putting that out there because he's curious, he's messy. He reminds me of Brandon Marshall. Have you heard of Brandon Marshall?
Yes.
And his new I Am Athlete podcast. He's a type in the podcast that says, all right, you have the facts, you have the feelings, I like to get messy. And to agree with you, Jazz, okay, I definitely think Will likes to get messy.
Mm-hmm. And I mean, I know it's also a Libra thing. Will Smith's birthday was actually the other day, and I do know that he is a Libra, just like myself. But yeah, the interactions I've had with Libra men, they are a little messy. Not to put y'all on blast.
Just put an example out there. Bebe, you got this.
Yeah. So, okay, basically, long story short, Libra men like to play games. They like to play games. So I think that Will Smith is, you know, he's probably playing a little game, you know, he's playing a little game with her because, you know, he thinks it's fun. And I get that because it's kind of probably, you know, a little bit of revenge sprinkled in there, you know, and a little bit of just like his personal feelings. And maybe he's just wanting to be like super open and honest about it. I don't know. But yeah, Libra men, they play games. They like to get in your head. And they mess with you. So
mess with you. What I'm trying to gather is the word that's coming to my head is manipulation. Something like that.
Just a little bit. Not like on some super, I'm going to manipulate you into doing something. But it's like they have you like double, triple thinking something over again. Like, yeah.
With all those thoughts make you in my really head, doubt yourself. Doubt is the word that's coming.
Yes.
Who wants doubt in a relationship? I want you to be my better half. I'm your rock. You know, that's how I go about it. But I think I'm gathering it. Wow, that's intense. And from your experience, you're telling me majority of the Libra men that introduce themselves to your life tend to carry themselves in this gamer mentality.
Mm-hmm. Very questionable. Okay. Mm-hmm. So
maybe they need to put down the joysticks. How about that? You know?
Stop playing. It's not fun for us. It's really not. But
you know, I can tie off that too. Sorry to interrupt, Jazz, but I know a good personal friend of mine. Again, I'm not going to put him on blast, but he's a Libra. He's a male. Mm-hmm. And he is quite the up and down. I've noticed. He comes to me for a lot of like support emotionally, and you know, some sort of spiritual advice. I'm a few years older than him. He looks to me with that big brother energy. I appreciate that. And my goodness, he tells me his adventures with his partners and stuff, and they always sound like what you just said. Like he was always looking to get an edge on his partner. Mm-hmm. And I'm like, for what? What edge are you looking for? To be better than them? Then maybe you two shouldn't even be together, period. So I'm gathering this, and I'm seeing it in my personal life too. So come on, Libra guys, you know, like let's put the joysticks down, fellas in general. All right, Libras or non-Libras, let's put the joysticks down, fellas.
Okay, please do, because y'all making the Libras look bad. Like every time I get on any type of social media platform, and somebody's, you know, having an argument or a discussion about the zodiac signs, they're always asking like, who's the worst? Or who's always lying and who does this and that? And people always like them lying Libras. And I literally see that all the time. And I'm just like, where do people be getting this from? It has to be the men. I'm sorry, but hey.
I just gave you an example of a male doing that. So you may not be wrong. All I'm saying, you know, I'm giving you facts to reemphasize your argument, Jazz. Yeah, so you got a point. Go on with it. Get deeper in it. Dive into this.
It's just, I really feel like, because I'm not trying to put nobody on blast. Like, I've met a lot of Libra men that I'm, like, really cool with, and we're friends. Like, it's not everybody, but I really think it's some problem, like, with the majority of Libra men. And I'm sorry, but I'm just not going to put that on myself. I'm not going to say Libra women, because I feel like all the Libra women I've met in my life are super chill, cool, don't be getting into no drama. They just like living a chill, cool life. We don't
That sounds like you. Exactly.
And that's pretty much like all the other Libra women I've met. They're pretty much just like me. We just be chilling. We don't want none of the drama. We ain't trying to play no games, because nobody has time for that. Nobody wants to be entangled up in that, because I just don't care enough. Like,
yeah,
no.
There's bigger things. There's better goals. There's more things I would like to accomplish personally, is what you're saying, right?
Yes. Great. That is exactly what I'm saying.
I'll put the nail in the coffin too, because I want to tie into what you're saying. Like, so I read tarot, I read stars, I study, you know, planets and stuff, and I love astrology. Not saying it's concrete evidence, but from what I can gather from my learning is the following. Libras, male or female, are encouraged to find balance. Their life, their symbol is all about balance. Their struggle is finding the correct balance, and they're virtuous, meaning they like to defend other people. They like to fight for people. That's what I'm gathering from Libras, right?
Yeah, so, absolutely.
So if we take that to a male versus female comparison, I know personally as a male, and from my experiences with other males and boys and growing up, I think men aren't as in tune with their emotions as, say, a woman is. Can we agree on that?
Yes, I think we can agree out there, folks. Yeah. If you agree, leave a comment, hit the like button. But yeah, I think you're right on topic with that.
And to add on to that, so what I'm saying is if a woman has one skill that makes her a little more in tune in balancing her emotions, she may come off as a little more complete, well put together, as far as a male maybe who is a Libra struggling to find his balance. It's probably not going to be so in tune or able, have the capacity to balance out their emotions. Feel me? So I could definitely see a trend in how, literally, like the scales of a Libra, I could see the men unable or still learning to get more control of their emotions, as opposed to a female Libra is like born out the gate in tune, you know, just because that's how it is. You know how it goes back to the theory how I think women are born with value and men have to earn their value in this life. But again, that's a story for another time. But I love this diving deep into someone's personality and bringing up spirituality. I love it, Jazz. Love this.
Yeah, I'm into that too. I'm super into it. Yeah.
Excellent.
I think we should do that more often.
Yeah. So Will, get it together.
Get it together. Find your balance, okay?
Yeah.
Find your balance, because we know it's within you. The Libra scales are within you. So just use it. Use it, okay? Balance yourself out. Yeah, absolutely. So next we have some more dating news. This is a very interesting couple that are apparently together now. The Weeknd and Angelina Jolie are dating.
What the age difference is that?
Oh, yeah, that's a good question. I didn't even think about that. Ooh, yeah, Angelina is kind of up there.
Right?
What is she, like, 50s? I think she's, like, in her 50s, and the Weeknd is
30. Born June 4th, 1975,
46. Oh, I tried to age. Sorry. Okay, yeah, I tried to say she in her 50s. I'm sorry, girl.
10 more years.
So he says she's 46 and he's 31.
31.
So 15 years age difference.
So now that brings it to the question too, like, you know.
Yeah, let's dive into that.
When you're over the age of 18, I think it's fair game, don't you?
Mm-hmm.
Take that same, here, let's do it because numbers would be easy. If she was 20 years old, how old would the week be? Feel me?
Yeah.
So that's kind of like robbing the cradle. But again, he's in his 30s, early 30s. She's in her mid 40s. So I think this could just be a phase he's going through. I don't think it's anything serious. First off, I don't take Hollywood too seriously. That's another note. But The Weeknd, I think
he's... Yeah, seriously. Seriously. Everybody be dating 1 week and be broken up the next.
Just like that. But I think The Weeknd, He's going through a phase in his life where he's curious about an older woman. Because I think before he was with a lot of younger, like a Selena Gomez, that one model that had Drake's baby, I think, right? I forgot her name.
Bella Hadid.
I think. Yeah, so I think he's still young enough. Well, 31 isn't young, but I think he's still young enough in his dating life where he's curious to see what it's like. Maybe he was tired of the youth and the energy and the spontaneity of a young woman, and he was looking for something more aged and proper, like a fine wine. You know, it could be just as curious. I think he's just having fun out there. Nothing too serious.
Me too. And you know what? I completely support it. I feel like you should do what you do. And I feel like I know my mom would definitely support it, because my mom, I ain't gonna bust you out, mom, but she liked that whole cougar thing. So anybody else that's being a cougar, she's gonna be like, yes, you better get it. So
yeah. Love is love, right? Love is love.
Absolutely. Love is love. So hey, it's all right. What isn't all right? This is another thing we could talk about, like.
Sure.
How drunk do you think is like an inappropriate amount to be like drunk in public? Because everybody knows Nicolas Cage. He was thrown out of a restaurant in Las Vegas this weekend for being completely drunk. But it's like,
what's completely drunk? Is it like above the 0.8 something?
Hmm. Oh yeah, that's like the I think it's 0.08, or is it 0.8?
Yeah, I pulled it up here. Like, non-commercial drivers age 21 and up are considered legally drunk when their blood alcohol is 0.08 or more.
Now Linda with the cougar emojis.
Rawr.
Okay. But no, on the Nicolas Cage. So it says that people saw him at a bar and they at first thought he was a homeless man. Because I guess he was looking rough, but they said he was being really drunk. He was being super rowdy and he was getting into a fight with the staff members there. So,
the question isn't the amount of alcohol, but what you do once you have it in you.
Right.
Maybe it's a behavior thing. Heck, maybe he needs therapy. A behavior therapist is the words that are coming to my head. I don't know.
I think so. Because the article is also saying that he lost his mom earlier this year. And he has revealed that he struggled with addiction like throughout his life. And he said back in 2018 to The Guardian that he's so obsessed with his work because it helps him avoid being self-destructive. So.
Ouch.
Yeah.
Ouch, man.
I think Linda said that before.
Mm-hmm.
So this is not the first situation, I guess, Nicolas Cage has gotten himself in.
So Mr. National Treasure is a repeat offender.
Yeah. Mm, that's unfortunate.
So many good movies.
Like, I know, like, so many. And it's like, yeah, I know she said this isn't the first time he's done that, but hopefully he'll get some type of help. Like, he has to have a support system. Somebody has to be out there looking out for Nicolas Cage, like, definitely look out for him. Don't let him tarnish his whole reputation going out and getting into pointless fights at bars. Like, that's just, no. I'm sure he's got
You said it.
It's pointless. He has, like, a big enough house, and I'm sure he has, like, some good friends if you want to go over and enjoy a little bit of, you know, whatever your poison is, pick your poison. But I'm really a firm believer in, like, if you want to go out, of course, that's fine. Like, have a good time. But you really can't start doing the most like that, like being rowdy and, you know, yelling at people and getting into fights for no reason. Because most of the time, everybody knows if you've had liquor before, that sometimes your emotions get a little like higher and you're a little more sensitive, just a little bit. And it's like if somebody says one thing to you, or they looking at me wrong, what they looking at, or, you know, somebody might accidentally brush your shoulder, but since you're drunk, you felt it as a boom, he bumped my shoulder. So you're like, oh, so he can't say excuse me? What's his problem? Like, just don't even put yourself in that situation is what I'm saying. Like, I know life is hard, and sometimes it's like people have their vices, like how they get through stuff. But sure. Especially when you're a public figure, it's like you gotta really reel that in. You gotta know how to reel that in.
Yeah. Yeah. If you wanna use alcohol as a coping method to help you along the fact that your mother has passed away, I see it. I don't condone it, but I acknowledge it. And I can see how you're using it. But my man, I think he's looking to set himself up so he can get in a fight. And this is definitely a macho thing where, like, you know, he's going to prove to himself that he can and will always protect and defend. And bro, like Nicolas Cage, man, if you're listening, which you're probably not, I would recommend, my man, you take that type of aggressive behavior to the countryside, my man. Either drink and get drunk by yourself because you're a public figure, or two, you know, head on over to someplace in the super rural, God knows where, in some bumble off type of neighborhood, right, out in the countryside where no one's going to hear you. And then you probably, you know, pick a fight with six bikers or something. I don't know. I just think he could have chose, because, like, when you choose to go in a public place,
he was in Las Vegas.
Of all places, you have to adhere to the public rules, don't you?
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Public behavior is necessary, my man. This guy sounds a little extreme. Sounds like he likes to bury himself in his work. Mm-hmm. Sounds like a Capricorn.
He just might be. When was he born?
Google, save us now.
When was Nicolas Cage born, folks?
January 7th, 1964. Okay. Is that not a cap? He's a cap, but there's two times of caps. There's the December caps and January caps. Way different behavior. So the January Capricorn, I'm a Capricorn myself, December 26th. But the January caps, not to hate on them, but like they're supposed to be the young, up-and-comers, full of energy, like, the early bird gets the worm type attitude. You know, bushy-tailed, bright-eyed, ready to go. And then the December caps are more laid-back, chill. Wisdom, old man style, you know, and I think he's just he's playing to his zodiac. He's acting himself.
Yeah.
Because kids get into fight because they have a lack of information or a lack of self-control. Adults tend not to get into fights unless they don't have the information or lack self-control.
I agree with that wholeheartedly. So message of the day is, folks, as I wrap up my entertainment report, we're about to go to Young Homie for the weather update. Message of the day. Just if you feel like getting turned up for whatever reason it may be, just watch yourself. Okay. Watch yourself. And what they say, check yourself before you wreck yourself.
Yes. That's an oldie, but a goodie.
Yeah. An oldie, but a goodie. Check yourself before you wreck yourself. Especially when you out here in the public eye like that. It's a bad look, and you don't want the bad looks on you. You don't want that. Okay?
Seriously.
So, yeah. Keep that in mind. Check yourself before you wreck yourself. And right now, I'm going to pass it over to Young Homie.
Thank you again, Jasmine. Appreciate it. What's up, Chicago Worldwide? If you're tuning in, this is the Wake Up and Win Show with your boy DJ Young Homie live here in Chicago. It's currently 79 degrees. It's going to be sunny. It's going to be beautiful. The high is going to be 86. So you may need some shorts out there. You know what I'm saying? It's still summer by today's aspects. You know what I'm saying? So get out there and enjoy the sun, because tonight it's going to be cold. It's going to be 63 degrees. And if you want gear that can handle all types of weather, like the weather here in Chicago, head on over to teespring.com/YSG, or since I got good SEO now, you could type in Young Street Gear in your Google search bar today. Back to you, Jazz.
Hey, thank you. Thank you for that. I was like saying, like the whole time you were saying the weather update, I was like holding it in because I was really confused. You said it's going to be a high of 86 today, correct?
Yeah. Isn't that nuts? High of 86 around 3 p.m.
Is it not about to be October 1st on Friday?
Let me check the calendar. Hold on. Oh, I
could have sworn it's about to be October.
October in 4 days.
And it's 86 degrees today, y'all. That's really some Chicago stuff for you right there. I don't really know what else to say. That's just straight Chicago.
That's nuts.
Absolutely nuts. But Yeah, this is the Wake Up and Win show. Thank you for tuning in. We are going to be right back with a little One's Gotta Go before our interview with Mr. Trae Till himself. So yes, we shall be right back.
Hey, this is Dino and Angelo Luciano, and you're listening to the Wake Up and Win show with Jazzy Fierce, DJ Young Homie, and Don Julio, Baby Doll.
What's good, y'all? Thank you so much for tuning in to the Wake Up and Win show today. Do not forget you can check out our homepage.
I feel just like Juice, y'all. RP the Juice World forever in our heart. Still here in spirit, so he not too far apart. Standing at the finish line, but not on when to start. Just like him, before I leave this world, I gotta leave my mark. So watch me pop up on Billboard's top charts like a Pop-Tart. Came a long way from pushing pills and riding hot cars. Call me Static Shock, cause when I touch the hood, they feel a spark. The booth is like a canvas, and my flows and lyrics make the art. Lord, please keep blessing me, and all my bros with felonies. Eliminate my enemies and anyone who plot on me. Yeah, the ecstasy get the best of me, but ain't too much that's really stressing me. Illuminate my neck and wrist, they can't help but to notice me, but my confessions in the booth, I just wanna tell the truth. Who want war ain't no truce. I ain't come for complications, I just came for all the loot. That's the vibe that you get from me when I'm fresh in the stoop, man. Yeah. My confessions in the booth, I just wanna tell the truth. Who want war ain't no truce. I ain't come for complications, I just came for all the loot. That's the vibe that you get from me right now, man. That's just how I'm feeling. My confessions in the booth, I just wanna tell the truth. You know, just keep everything 1K with y'all. Just no bullshit. Look.
When I started rapping, no opinions, I gave all facts. Dealt with situations, but I had to learn to fall back. He don't want that beef, cause I grill him with a Big Mac. Miss my brothers, and some of them hate that I can't call back. Put my life on the line, even went against the grain for you. But that was my decision, there ain't nothing you can make me do. Talk behind my back, I used to pray to God it wasn't true. Crazy how they smile on your face, but don't even fuck with you. It's all love, though. Psych, cold-hearted life with all the fucking love, go. Said you 100 with you, acting like a fucking Delpho. Since then nothing was the same, I'm on my Drake flow, but I learned to live and let go. But I finally found a woman, she been with me through the thick and thin, and she deserves
hey,
the
what's
best
going on, world? It's your boy Don Julio from the Wake Up Win Show, and our friends at Down to Earth wanted us to remind you guys that Down to Earth is a beauty brand. A brand can count on for great service and high quality product at an affordable price. If you haven't already, let Down to Earth find a place in your home. For more information, visit Facebook, keyword D2E.
What's good, everybody? Welcome back to the Wake Up and Win show. We got your boy DJ Young Homie right over her, and we got your girl Jazzy Fierce right here. So yeah, I feel like we need to get into a little bit of discussion before we do One's Gotta Go and before we get to our interview with Trae Till. So Young Homie, what we got to talk about today?
No, absolutely. Thank you, Jasmine. I came across a great article, and it had to do with a mother taking her child, 11-year-old child, a bigger child, still a child. And I think I'll just pull up the article, and I'll read it to you guys. And it goes like this. Awesome. Haunted house actor accidentally stabs 11-year-old
while trying to scare her
the real night. So just to sum it up, you know, it's here we go. So here's the last name. I know I'm going to butcher it, but Pogazelski was playing the part of a roaming scare actor outside the haunted attraction and was dragging a large knife to spook people before they entered. Right. So what ended up happening was he went to his car to get a real to get a real knife. And that real knife ended up stabbing the kid in his foot. The kid was wearing Crocs. All right, here we go. It was in Ohio, Seven Floors of Hell was the location. It's one of those scary places like a corn maze or something. It says, I guess he got a little too close. It was complete accident and poked the boy's toes, Gerfick told News 5. He has defended Pogazelski as a popular actor at other haunted attractions in the area and said that their policy is to only use rubber props. So this is horrible. Like so the mother was trying to get some justice or some action from the staff that were working there, but they said, hey, we're not certified to apply first aid. So you got an 11-year-old bleeding from his toe, and the mom's looking to get some sort of help, so she ends up calling the police. So
yeah,
here's another quote. I didn't want to make a scene, of course. I wanted to go about it in the appropriate way, said Bonarski. The biggest thing for me, you know, is I don't understand the mental state of this man. There's got to be something wrong with him, and he should not be working in an establishment like that, which makes me upset. Bonarski is a police officer that was communicating with Channel 5 News that day. But can you believe that the guy, he was given a prop, you know, he ended up going to his car to get a real knife.
Yeah.
That's intent. Like, that's tough. Like, I don't know if I would ever take my child to something like this. So then my question to you, Jazz, is here we go. Oh, I'm lagging. All right. How old is too young to start taking children to locations like this?
Man, before haunted houses got super crazy, because this is not the first time I've heard something like this. Like, the workers were doing something they weren't supposed to be doing, using real weapons instead of the fake props they're given. They really started doing way too much with these haunted houses, I feel like, in the last at least maybe 5 to 7 years. But I feel like maybe before that, I think a decent age to start bringing kids to, not the little ha ha he he haunted houses, not those. We're talking about the real hardcore ones that are supposedly supposed to be super scary, and everybody, it's usually adult groups that go, mm-hmm. things like that. I feel like it should be maybe teenagers that go, at least 13, 14. Because you said the little guy was 11 years old and he ended up getting stabbed in the foot because dude want to play around with real knives. So
he was wearing Crocs.
That's crazy. And it's you should be able to wear Crocs and open-toed shoes at a haunted house and not have to worry about getting stabbed because people are on some other stuff. I don't even know what was wrong with that worker. I agree with the police officer. Something's definitely wrong with him, because yeah, who does that?
No one, I think, with at least one half of a brain, the great thing is the officer kind of took this to heart and be like, whoa, whoa, whoa. This guy has been, he's had multiple complaints. He has done this before in similar situations.
See, yeah, he shouldn't have even had a job. How did that happen? Exactly. How did they let that happen?
Exactly, because the people that they hire at these corn mazes, haunted houses in the middle of an asylum, they don't do
it. You ain't gonna catch me there.
Yeah, I just
not a corn maze.
Yeah, exactly.
I don't like those.
Well, how about Fright Fest? Do you think Fright Fest here in Chicago, Gurnee, Six Flags, a little more watered down when compared to this?
Yeah. And see, I was a person that went to Fright Fest. This was, I think, maybe when I got straight out of high school. So this was some years ago, but I was still scared. People was running up on me and I was still scared, and it wasn't even scary for real like that, but I was still scared. So I feel like maybe the kids 14, 15, under, maybe they just need to stick to the watered down stuff, because apparently they going too crazy with these real haunted houses using real weapons. That's crazy.
Yeah. Not gonna lie, just like you, Jazz, I went to about 3 corn mazes. I went to one that was like a hotel, but with a bunch of things too. Now, I actually hate these things personally. I do not like Halloween. That's just me. It's not. I'm a Christmas guy. Hey, let's get presents. Let's drink hot chocolate. Let's have a great time. But yes, the Halloween really was never for me, and I got coaxed into it. Peer pressure. Like, I'd go to these corn mazes with a girl that wanted to go, and she's like, "Well, you should go, and you know, you're a tough guy. You should do it, you know." And I'm like, "Man, first off, that's a bad impersonation of the girls I go with." Anyway, secondly,
that was bad. I'm like, they sound like men. Okay, I see what you mean.
Oh no! But every time I noticed, like, it was the majority group was curious about it. But again, though, we were all about 17, 18, 19 years old going about these. We weren't 11 years old wearing Crocs, holding my mom's hand every now and then. No, like, we consciously went in there knowing that there, you know, we could trip and fall. We can, you know, might bump our heads by accident. They make you sign a waiver, don't they? At most of these places.
Yeah.
They're not held liable for their actions. So if you're doing that and you're signing away your rights, don't let me in. I'm not going. I need all my rights.
No, for real. Like, I feel like, how are they going to make an 11-year-old sign a waiver?
Mm-hmm.
So
they
it's
wouldn't.
Like, what is...
They would have the mother do it.
Right.
The mother would sign away
your rights. I don't know, man. That's a tough situation. And as I said, it's sad that you can't even bring your kids to a haunted mansion or a haunted house, whatever the heck, without getting stabbed because people want to play and use real weapons instead of the props that they are given. That's wild.
That's wrong. That's some sort of justice needs to be done on this guy, man. You cannot. Literally, he went to his car to get a real knife to replace the prop knife he was given. Come on now. You got something off on that. You got to handle that.
Yeah, same reaction. Okay. Mm-mm-mm.
Well, enough of the somberness. On a brighter note, we have a great interview in the house. A great, talented man. I can't even introduce him because the list of
you
talents
can it. You can do it.
Skills. Is
I'm rooting for you.
He's got a new single titled "Net." He is right here from Chicago. He is Trae Till. On the Wake Up and Win Show.
Hey, clap it up.
Appreciate it.
What's good, Trae?
What's going on, y'all?
Great.
Shoot, nothing. Chilling. Doing a show.
Trying to get like y'all, man.
Please. We trying to get like you. But I just want to know, like, are we at the table? Because I know the project is not at the table. Are we at the table?
Y'all one of the founders, bro. Y'all good. Y'all like that.
bet. So let's get right into this, Trae. We have had you on the show before. This was in like February, I want to say. So it's been a minute. How are you?
Yeah, time flew.
Yeah, it really did. So tell all of our new winners, our new listeners out there, just a little bit about yourself.
I'm, like they said, a great introduction. I'm Trae Till. I'm an artist. Poetry is my primary, but I dabble in a couple other lanes. I'm from Chicago, out west, 290, our Raven Raiders, you know, we kill West House. I'm from out west. I just do poetry. I ran into Jazz, and, you know what I'm saying? She blessed, allowed me to come on, and we took off ever since. So, you know what I'm saying?
That's how we do. So you definitely got to just, let me say this. You got to let people have their shine when they're talented. You can't just be like, oh, you know, they underground. They ain't got 50,000 followers. Ain't nobody worried about them. Like, trust me, you're going to miss out on so many gems if you think like that.
Facts.
You can't buy talent. I really think, you know, you either got it or you don't. Or you're working towards getting better at it.
No, and you always gonna have to work, period. That's just the cold hard truth in some cases, you know what I'm saying? You gotta be dope, because the audience gonna feel it. And if they don't feel it, they gonna move on. That's gonna always be the most candid reaction or game you can do.
Exactly. No, I agree 100%. So I want you to tell us, I was going to say just where you got the inspiration for Not at the Table, but then I also want to know what's your favorite track on there and why.
Both.
Yeah.
inspiration for Not at the Table. So if you haven't noticed already, like, I favor wordplay. So when doing it, when I chose the title, I knew, like, especially for, I don't want to just say like my peer group, but especially for the people that my peers knew, that knew other people, that knew other people, like just the macro picture. I knew not at the table would initially like make somebody wonder like, oh, so he dissing somebody, like they not coming up with him, they not elevating, they ain't gonna make it. But that wasn't even the case at all. So it was more so about topics and issues like that we typically should discuss at the table where everybody's present, has a voice, but choose not to just because, so in some cases, it can step on toes, whether it's your own personal experiences or like the macro view of a situation or event that's impacted everybody. So that was the inspiration for the title. So once I had that, like the pieces kind of, you know what I'm saying, called out their own spot on the track list in a way, because I already knew like what I wanted to paint as far as, you know what I'm saying, that picture with the title, so not at the table. So it was stuff that came out of my own personal battles, like my peers, my family, people I know, as well as society in a whole. It's a balanced piece of work, you know. So I mean, yeah.
Okay. I'm feeling that. That was deep.
It was. And he brought up that word that we said earlier, balance.
Yes. A lot of people do not focus on that balance, and everybody needs that balance in their lives. And it don't matter what you want to do with your life, you still need balance, because without that, you are going to fall and fall hard.
Yeah. Every time.
Yeah, for real. So now to my second question. I know I had a loaded question, but yeah. So I guess maybe not even so much what's your favorite track off of it. What was like the one you had the most fun creating?
Let's go with that. Most fun creating. Let me think real quick. Give me a second. We got it. The one I had the most fun creating will probably be Bittersweet. Simply because it's the, everybody feel it, like regardless of your age. Now, granted, the terminology I use is probably like more my age, you know what I'm saying? But the concept is a one size fits all. So like, it's basically like the reason men are the way they are and the reason women are the reason men are the way they are, you know? So it's like, well, with a little humor and satire sprinkled on it. So like, that was the most fun because I already knew, for those who really like listen to tap in, like it's gonna strike them. It's gonna like, it caused this conversation. Like it's icebreaking. Like you play that and then people gonna first, who is this? And then second, what are you talking about? And then once they hear it, it's like, that was the fun. That was the fun piece of me. Nice.
Okay. So what you telling me is I'm gonna literally need every single track on that album, and I'm gonna need that in MP3 form so we can get it on the show. Sure. Right? Okay, bet. Bet, homie, you got some questions?
Of course. Instead of having an open-ended question like, what's your creative process? How do you go about this? What is your muse? I want to get to the realistic part. I want you to tell me step by step on how you go about recording any song. Like, do you record by yourself? Do you go to a studio? Do you book time? Do you collaborate with a producer? Or is it all in-house and it's done by you? What are the steps on how Trae Till records his songs?
Okay, so recording process, it's definitely not in-house. I definitely collaborate with a producer. Actually, it's kind of interesting. It was a couple producers for this particular project, but not at the table. Jay Baby, he's from the house out. Oh, shout out to my boy, Jay Baby.
Okay, out south. Hey.
Glorious, actually from Houston. I'm missing one. Shame on me, I'm missing one. But it's actually four, but right now I'm kind of out of, y'all call me off guard. But hey, it's a collaboration of a couple of producers on this particular project. And they helped, because it took a second, honestly, even though it was only, what, I think 11 or 10 tracks. It took a second because I was in a lot of, I was in the middle of transitioning. So I was still trying to like stay on my word, like, okay, I'm gonna deliver it here, da, da, da. Still trying to, I remember our last interview, we was talking about like goals for the year. and mine was exposure. So like one of the tools of the grassroots effort with that is promotion. So like I was still trying to promote and stay, like I was really just trying to balance, you know what I'm saying? Just keep balance. So yes. And I feel like I did a pretty good job with it. But yeah, I go to the stool as many times as I need to, as long as I need to, until I get what I saw in my head or what I heard, you know what I'm saying, or both. And I come back, if it's not what I thought, feel me, I do it again.
Yeah. Wow, two words come to my head after that answer. I'm hearing resilient and I'm hearing work. You know, work is is a part of everybody's life. You know, you're going to have to put in some work if you really want something. Yeah. And I think your resiliency is key to getting good work out.
In life, like, you're going to get, you know, I mean, we all know, you're going to get knocked down. So, I mean,
Right.
It doesn't matter how many times you get knocked down. It matters when you get up.
Every time you get up, all the time. So.
Yeah. I have one more question, and then we're going to run a video from our friend Don Julio, who sent us a video to ask you a question. But my last question is, how important is it for artists to own their masters? Where'd the audio go? Uh-oh.
Yeah. Oh, wait, there it is.
Here we go. Let's try it again.
You?
Yes.
Okay, all right.
How important is it for an artist to own their masters?
It's extremely important. But before I elaborate on it, I will say it's extremely important, period. But as long as the situation is in your favor when you don't. So like if you're trying to leverage it, you know what I'm saying? You got people that typically, you know what I'm saying, in these situations they have the chance to lobby their masters. They come from nothing, like, I mean, nothing. So, and if in their eyes, they see, like, if I could get to this point where I could leverage this much of this piece of work, I can create something else. Like, I'm saying, like, so for those people, like, I don't want to, like, always say it's very important, you know what I'm saying, you need to own them, blah, blah, blah. But at the same time, I do get what you're saying. Like, it's very important to the masters. Because if you don't, I mean, like, that's a lot of hard work. Royalties, man, you talking about residual income, you talking about, like, a lot of stuff. So, like, you want to get that up, I hope you got something else on reserve, you know, but if you don't, you know, I mean, you threw away a lot of days you could have chilled, you know. It's very important on you, man. So.
Well said. I appreciate it. Jasmine, do you have the video for Don Julio that you can roll for us
real quick?
Thank you so much.
Question number one.
Hey, what's going on? This is this question is for Trae Till. First off, before I ask you this question, man, it's an honor to have you on the show again. It's a pleasure to play your music here on the Wake Up and Win show. You got some great tracks, so keep the work up. But yeah, first question, man. What motivates you, man? What keeps you going, Trae Till?
I heard him say, "What keeps me going?" What did he say before that?
Yeah, what motivates you and what keeps you going?
Okay, what motivates, what keeps me going? That's a good question. That's a good question. I say it changes, bro. So like for me, like where I pull from for different pieces and projects is sometimes different. But if just being candidly pain, confusion, a lot of questions that I have, my peers have, sometimes they can't get answers. So it's like, it's just inquiring sometimes, you know what I'm saying? Being open-minded, trying to figure some stuff out. So like, what keeps me going though, is that when I write, like, that's my getaway from here. So that's like a cheap vacation. So like, it's like, that's what keeps me going. It's almost selfish, because when I go there, I'm gone.
Right.
Yeah, we all need breaks.
Exactly. So like, that's what keeps me going a lot. And knowing, regardless of, like, you know what I'm saying, I guess the quantity of the who hears it, as long as I'm getting like quality feedback, like, you know what I'm saying, like people saying like, "Nah, I felt that shit." Like, "Nah, for sure." Like, that's what I'll be looking for. That's the money for me.
So, right. Yeah. I agree. I kind of feel the same way about that. Like, that people underestimate how much that can really help you and keep you going with whatever you're doing. Like, just a simple acknowledgement. It ain't got to be no, you know, super, oh my God, you are so amazing type stuff like that. Yeah, nah, just let me know that you felt what I was saying and you get me. Yeah.
For me, like, when because I kind of visualize what would be felt if I was hearing this, if I was on hearing the end. So, like, I look for in a certain response sometimes if it's brought up. It's not like I'm just like, here, now, what you feel? Like, it's not like that. But it's like when it comes up and we talking about it, like, that's how I kind of know, like, you feel me? So, exactly. I don't care about the rest of the stuff. Like, as long as I know, okay, yeah, you felt that. And then sometimes people got different interpretations of it, and that's like the coolest part. I'll be like, dang, I ain't even, you know what I'm saying? Well, I didn't expect you to be, to relate or that for the, you feel me? So,
right. Man, life. But yes, we have another question from Don Julio. So let me play that for you right now.
And my next question for you, Trae Till. Once again, before I get to the question, it's an honor to have you on the show again. Thank you very much. It's a pleasure to have you. But yeah, how do you get started on your music, writing your music? Do you have a process? Because, man, you got some lyrics, bro.
Period. Did you hear that?
I missed it again.
He was saying, like, what is pretty much like your writing process? Because he said you got some lyrics on you, you got some bars.
Oh, my writing process.
And I was like, period.
Ooh, y'all want the song? Okay.
don't give us the recipe. Just give us a little bit, okay?
Right? Just a little bit.
Now I'm playing. Honestly, I call them downloads. You know, it's just like, you know what I'm saying? Sometimes it'll hit me in a wave. You feel me? Like, and by wave, I mean like the whole piece in its entirety. Like, I get it. I just write it out. Or sometimes, like, I get, you know what I'm saying, a couple. And once that hit, I chill, write it down. I go over my name. And something else hit me. Okay. Add it. And that's like one of the main two, for sure. Like, but like right now for that, the Not at the Table, it was really like all waves, to be honest, for each piece. And the only difference was the occasions that it called me on. It was just like different occasions, but it was like a wave for sure. I didn't really have to sit too long and kind of, you know what I'm saying, ponder on it, like normal other pieces. Yeah, that's right.
That's great. It's like you're constantly thinking. It's like this music thing never quits. It's not like you take a break.
Yeah,
it's a life.
Yeah, and that's good for me. Yeah, exactly. Like, that's good because I don't like being still. So, like, yeah, I gotta constantly do something. So why not be productive? That's what I'm doing.
Yes, yes, amen. Why not productive? Why not? And here, you're listening to the Wake Up and Win Show, and we got a great, great artist by the name of Trae Till. We're glad you joined us today. And if you guys missed the interview, be sure to check us out wherever you get your podcast, keywords, Wake Up and Win.
Shout out.
Period. So we do have a song from Nat that we want to play called Fatal Fantasy. So if you want to introduce that for us.
Oh, yes. So
it's all yours.
Fatal Fantasy, it's kind of a mellow but milder piece. You know, it's more introspective, you know what I'm saying, inside my own brain, you know what I'm saying, but with a little more entertainment glossed over. So hopefully, you know what I'm saying, you tap in, you enjoy. Straight there.
All right, let's get it.
Sorry, he had a dream. Somebody was gonna murder me. Had a witch as an urgency. They upon attention, never even occurred to me. I grew up in a rackety. Only if the audacities should get real. So real, you rather make believe. Your brother signed me for the cake and cheese. Aim and squeeze two strap like some duggarees. He got two of them stunk like a bumblebee. Rare flow, honestly, you shine on me. I speak crap, write the facts, call it honesty. No, yes, you were. Now it's a dichotomy. Pride calls device, and we're something that we proud to be. I'm painting pictures of truth, something the crowd can see without the cloud. You see? Mm-hmm.
It ain't even been a minute. Wait a minute, what's a minute? What's a limit? Fantasies and fallacies, car realities, high in the cloud, fighting principalities. Know a hole in a high rise by the gallery. Lover watching calories, viper in the dress, mind in my pants, dancing with the devil, mold in the dance. Can't hear her hooves the way she pressed. Hunger for more, I watch the sunrise. Hoes duck in the earth for it's the same size. See, I see things different, ain't got the same eyes. Yeah, I'm changing, but nigga, keeping the mob ties. Holding on to the time, cause you know time flies. Trae Till, wake up. Almost time pops, heat the lake up. Dead man walking, pick the paper up. Clues everywhere, pick a trace up. Truth in my shoe, watch him lace up. And next time. Y'all hear me?
Let me hear that.
Man, that was great. I know a few words stuck out to me right away. You know, what's time? What's a limit? Yeah. And that's so true. You want to be limitless. You know, you don't want to be bound by time. I love that. Certain words that you say stick with me, Trae, and I appreciate you coming here on the Wake Up and Win Show. Great track.
Appreciate it, bro.
Yeah,
I don't even have words. I don't even have words. And I heard this song for the first time like a week ago, over a week ago. And it's like, I still don't really know what to say. Like, damn. All I can say is all hits, no misses. Mr. Trinfield, all hits, no misses. Okay. That's all I really got to say. Like, no misses.
Appreciate that wordplay.
Even like just your voice, like I'm gonna put myself on blast. But I was telling homie before no sound check. Yeah, I'm gonna put myself on blast. I was like, tell me why he was just talking to me, like just talking. You was just like, oh, you know, what's up, Jazz? Like, oh, just making sure everything's cool. And I was like, it sounds like he's on a track, like just the way you were talking. I was just like, damn, like it's the voice for me. It's the voice. Like
again, round of applause for Mr. Smooth Operator. I really really appreciate music I can hear on repeat. I can hear it over and over again, and that's every time you submit a track, Trae, it's been the same. I have it. I don't have an MP3 player. I put on my cell phone, put on the AirPods, and I enjoy it, man.
Hey, that's the goal. Hey, that means more than money to me, bro. Appreciate that for real, bro.
No problem, man. Appreciate it. Right here, from the heart, man. I respect real artists, and you are definitely beyond real.
See that quality feedback right there, yeah.
Yeah.
Hey, quality.
Don't be luck. I'm that guy who thinks a best friend is going to tell you to get your ish together.
For sure.
For sure. I'm the first one to say thumbs down on everything. So
So true.
Yeah, I appreciate it. And thank you again, man. Trae, wonderful. Oh, great smile. Great smile, Lynn. You are right.
Okay. Now my mom's trying to flirt with the artist.
Hey, man.
Okay.
Let mom be. Mom is mom.
I'm dead. I'm gonna let you do you, ma. But no, thank you. Thank you so much, Trae. Oh, you said put you on?
Nah, I said let him be grown.
Oh. I was like, okay.
She's gonna do this. And this is no. I'm out of this mess. We're getting messy in here.
It's getting very messy, folks. Very messy.
Yeah, y'all crazy.
Appreciate you again, Trae. You're always welcome to come back on the show. We're going to be bumping your track, and we're definitely going to submit it in our version of Cop It or Drop It. So we want to thank you again for being a part of the Wake Up and Win Show today. And it's been a pleasure, my man. Thank you so much.
All right, Jeff.
All right, we'll talk to you soon. Thank you.
You're welcome.
Peace out.
Awesome. What a great interview, Jazz.
Ladies and gentlemen, that was Trae Till. Definitely check out his project, Not at the Table. It is out now on all your listening platforms. So wherever you get your music, wherever you listen, just search him up, Trae Till. Project is called Nat. So check him out. You won't be sorry.
Yeah. And be sure to spell Trae right. I know some people out there are spelling his name T-R-E-A. That's Trae. That's a whole other thing, all right? This is Trae. Trae Till. Great guy.
Trae. Get it right. T-R-A-E. Trae.
Shots fired. Today's a wild show, Jasmine.
It is, but it's been so much fun.
Yeah, appreciate your time too. Everybody tuning in, hit the like button. Be sure to subscribe. We're chucking out videos twice a week, every week. And how about this, Jazz? Maybe we can run a top five Logic promo and then maybe dive right into the promo.
Yeah, I think we should do that.
Sounds good. We'll be right back, everybody.
Peace out, Girl Scouts.
Big shout out to DJ Young Homie. Thank you so much for another super lit top five right here on the Wake Up and Win show. And don't forget, the top five is brought to you by WLGK Logic Radio. And all you have to do to hear more of the top five is just tune in every Monday and Wednesday from 11 a.m. to 1 p.m. and download that Logic Radio app. All you have to do is download it in the Google Play or Apple Store, or you could just listen online, and that's logicradio.live.
Hey, Shorty, right there, cute. She pretty. I like her.
Big ups to the hair. I'm liking the how you had in the front of the curls right around this level. I'm digging it.
Yeah. Yeah.
I grew up with sisters, so I know how long great hair takes.
Man, it took a minute. So lots of curling on my own, and then I had to do like the little flexi rise. Have you seen those before?
No, I have not. Oh, wait, I have, where they're independent and they're like little, yeah. They look like mm-hmm. hot dog wieners. And then you, oh, yeah. My mom had one of those. I remember those. That's a throwback.
That's how you get the full effect, ladies. That's how you get the full effect with the curls. Do a little flexi rod action, leave it in overnight, take it down, boom, curls.
Man, just like, you make it sound so easy, Jasmine.
It's definitely going to take you a while, but it's worth
it. Especially with this. Oh, I don't have much to work with.
It's okay. Hair looks great. Looks
Thank
great
you again,
today.
Jan. Appreciate it. Appreciate everybody listening right now, watching us too. We're about to dive right into Thank the top you. Five. Today we mm-hmm. have DJ Khaled. I didn't know how many songs he's produced. This guy has his hands in everything.
Literally. Everything. Literally.
So we're going to dive right into this top five. It's going to be a quick top five, guys. Here's number five with Drake and DJ Khaled for free.
Five, four, three, two, one.
It's the WLGK
top five.
Yeah.
Let's go.
I go on and on. Can't understand how I last so long. I must have the superpowers. Last 223,000 hours. And it's cause I'm off of CC. And I'm off the Hennessy. And like your boy from Compton said, you know this ain't free. I got girls that are...
Should have made pay for it. Got girls that I should have made wait for it. Got girls that I should have to fly back home. Spend another day for it. You got attitude on nah nah.
Awesome. Great.
That was a bomb song, man.
It was.
And I remember when I first came out.
I tell you, when it first came out, when I was spinning around like 2018, I was dropping the strip club, and then like everybody had their hand up. Man, it was love. Great song.
Yeah, and that song is definitely good vibes.
Definitely. Continuing with our top five, we have number four with Jay-Z, Beyonce, and DJ Khaled, Shine.
Five, four, three, two, one.
It's the WLGK. I've been winning so long, it's like alchemy. I've been playing cards with the house money. 21 Grammys, I'm a savage. 21 Grammys, I'm a savage. Savage. I shoot even where I'm bad with 12 solo albums all platinum. I know you ain't, I ain't talking numbers right. I know you ain't, I ain't talking summers right. I know you.
Anything with Jay-Z and Beyonce on it is always gonna be a hit. I'm just saying.
You're definitely right. And number three, we got I Got the Keys.
Five, four, three, two, one.
It's the WLGK top five.
Major
Bag Alert.
DJ Khaled.
I got the keys, keys, keys. 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 We go to court and complete the field. I know the judge, I'ma shoot him some chips. I got the keys, keys, keys. I got the keys, keys.
Hey.
Yes. Shouts out to DJ Khaled, who looks like he could be my uncle. Number two, Wild Thoughts with Rihanna.
Five, five, four, three, two, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
It's the WLGK Top 5. Let's go.
Yeah, baby, baby, baby. Spinning in his red just like he came from Maytag. Rocket with sit on the brown. Like, when I get like this, I can't be around you. I'm too little to dim down a notch. Cause I can do some things that I'm gonna do.
Wow. Yes. The jam.
Sure. Hey,
I mean, another Rihanna. All hits, no misses.
All hits, no misses. And I did have a little trouble when I was buffering this last video. I wasn't able to. I wasn't able. It wasn't reading the actual song. But when I downloaded the instrumental and uploaded to the video editor, it took the instrumental. So now we're going to play number one. I did it, but it's just going to be the instrumental.
What?
5, 4, 4, 3, 3, 2, 1.
It's the WLGK Top 5. Let's go.
DJ Khaled. DJ Khaled.
That was funny. Like, low-key, I had never really thought about that, but it does look like he could be your uncle or something. And you're muted, but I'm pretty sure whatever you said was, like, so insightful and so fun.
I bet. But you know what, guys? We're actually strapped for time today. It's already going to be 12:30, and we want to appreciate you guys for tuning in. All the viewers,
thank you.
All the listeners, hit the like button, leave a comment. We'll get back at you guys on Wednesday. Jasmine, let's do some shout-outs.
Yes. So big shout-out to all of my friends, my family, my man, of course. Big shout-out to everybody that listened today and watched. We really appreciate you guys taking the time out of your afternoons to watch us, listen to us, and all of our shenanigans. Super big dumb shout-out to Trae Till for joining us today on the Wake Up and Win Show. Big, stupid, goofy shout-out. Yeah. Yeah.
It's big like that. Big.
Yeah. A big, great shout out to Trae Till, for real, though, on a real note. Thank you so much for joining us today. Again, check him out on Instagram at Trae Till. That's 3 L's. And make sure to spell Trae right, T-R-A-E dot Till, 3 L's. And check out his new project, Nat, Not at the Table. And you can check that out on all your platforms, wherever you listen to your music. So, yeah, I think that's a wrap for us. We'll be back on Wednesday.
Awesome. Quick shout out to Don Julio, who's not here, but with us in spirit. My son, big up, say it's a real important day. We got, you know, testing and stuff. I know he's going to do great. And of course, another big, dumb, goofy, enormous, gigantic, supersized shout out to Trae Till. You know what? He's so real. I'm going to leave you with this quote from Nipsey Hussle. Another real one. Rest in peace. Once you've had the real, it's hard to tolerate the plastic. Mic drop.
Felt that with my entire soul.
Right. Time to head downtown, yes. Jazz. See you downtown.
I know. See you soon. Peace out, guys. Peace out, Girl Scouts.